They like to share.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Oh my god. I'm speechless. It's something I've dreamed of all my life, you know, from the opening the doors in 2002. But we got there, boys. We got there. I mean, we used to discuss this in the pub after work at night. We didn't have too many customers in the early days, so we always did the ordering in the pub, and we always just sit there and dream about one day having just this. And you know, for all my team, and then we got there, which is just unbelievable feeling, I have to say. To be the eighth three-star in Great Britain and Ireland is just a massive dream come true. I would describe my cuisine as natural, innovative, and very tasteful. I like to have the menu reading like a poem, you know, like it to have rhythm. You know, things are put together in a way to sort of take into account taste, texture, flavour obviously is all important, but you know, I want it to flow and to really, you know, really for people to have the most amazing experience. Well, the latest dish we've added to the menu is a reworking of our anvil dish, our signature dish, which is a caramel miso. We make our own miso with quinoa. It's served on caramelised apples, and then at the table a pine and apple jus. It's different because it bears the 20-year logo on it, so it's very personal. The most challenging dish I've created my team, there's been a few. I suppose in the early years when we were pushing and a little bit more experimental, we had a dish where we did a deconstructed hot pot, lamb hot pot, using Herdwick lamb. There was a lot of technique that went into that, and it was very challenging. My team inspires me to get up every day and do what I do. My team invigorate me. They push me forward to make things better every single day. So for that, I'm really grateful. I first fell under the spell of the kitchen was probably when I was working in a Greek restaurant in Southampton at the age of 13. I absolutely love food. My father was a fruit and vegetable salesman. So I had an interest in ingredients even back then. In Cumbria, we were very fortunate enough for amazing suppliers to come to us with their produce. So it's fairly easy, really. But see, we look at what they've got. We test them out. See, you know, how they process their produce, and just the way they trade. You know, we want to work with parties that share the same ethos or understandings as we do. The advice I would give to the next generation of chefs is choose, you know, who you want to work with wisely. But go and work there, go and work there, do a stage, see if you get on with them as much as they get on with you. That's what we always do at L Enclume. But like I said, work hard, keep your head down, absorb as much information as you can, and if you are patient, this can be the most rewarding industry in the world.